Hello friends, this video on neural control and coordination part 9 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam.
So now we will talk about the detailed process of generation and conduction of nerve impulse. Now when I say generation of nerve impulse, we will see that how the nerve impulse gets generated. When a stimulus is received by a dendrite, how an electric impulse is generated. That is one thing that we will see here. The next thing we will see how that electric impulse is conducted from the dendrite to the axon endings of a neuron. So how it is conducted or how it is transmitted within one neuron. So that we will see in conduction of nerve impulse. So now this is very, very important to understand that how this process takes place, because this explains the entire basics of the nervous system. Now, excitability of neurons, that is the main reason why this entire process can take place. And what is the cause of excitability? The excitability of neurons is due to the polarization of the neuron membrane. Now, what is the meaning of polarization? Now, the concept of polarization comes into picture whenever there is a difference in charge. So, whenever you have an area where one region has a lot of positive charge, the other region has a lot of negative charge, what happens? There is a potential difference which exists between the two regions across that region. And this potential difference makes that region polarized. That means we see that they have got different charges in that region, so that then it is known as, it is said to be polarized. Now similarly, the neuron membrane, that is the membrane which binds the neuron or which is present surrounding the neuron, that is also polarized. So now the question is, how is the neuron membrane polarized? Now even before that, what kind of membrane is this which is present surrounding the neuron? So we need to understand more about the neuron membrane, and then we need to understand why is the neuron membrane polarized. Now when we talk about polarization of the neuron membrane, as I said, I am basically talking about a difference in charges. So whenever there is a difference in charges, that you have positive charges on one side and you have negative charges on one side, what will happen? A potential difference will exist. So when we talk about the concept of polarization of the neuron membrane, we will talk about two types of potential. One is the resting membrane potential. That means the potential difference which exists across the membrane of the neuron when it is in the resting phase. Now again, what is the meaning of resting phase? That means when the neuron is not conducting any impulse. So the neuron is not doing anything. It is just sitting idle. That is what we mean by rest. When we say I am taking rest, I mean I'm not doing anything. Similarly, if a neuron is in the resting phase, that means it is not conducting any impulse. It is not doing anything, right? So even at that time, the neuron membrane is polarized. That means there is a potential difference which exists even in the resting phase. So that potential difference is known as the resting membrane potential. And there is another type of potential which is called action potential. So this is the potential difference which exists across the membrane of the neuron when it is conducting the impulses. So these are the two types of potentials which we will talk about regarding the neuron membrane. As I said, resting membrane potential that exists across the neuron membrane when the neuron is not conducting any impulse, and action potential is that potential difference when the neuron conducts impulses. Okay, so this is just the first slide, and I do not want to give you so much of information that you get overloaded and you don't understand anything. So the main thing that we are going to discuss now is this generation and conduction of nerve impulse across one neuron happens due to potential difference. And this potential difference exists when the neuron is not doing anything, it is in the resting phase. Potential difference also exists when it is conducting the nerve impulse. So first we have to understand the neuron membrane structure, and you have to understand what kind of membrane it is. Then we will understand resting membrane potential. Then we will understand action potential, and then we will see that how these potential difference help in generation and conduction of nerve impulses. Clear? So I think I have set the agenda clear. What are we going to do in the next few slides?
Okay.
So now first let us understand the structure of the neuron membrane. So what kind of a membrane is present surrounding the neuron? Now whenever this membrane word comes to our mind, a very common membrane that you may remember is the plasma membrane. We have spoken about plasma membrane multiple times. And what is it? How is the structure of a plasma membrane? It is a lipid bilayer structure, two layers of lipids. So they are sandwiched with each other. That is a lipid bilayer structure of plasma membrane. Now here also, if you look at the neuron, so this is the neuron. So here basically you have a membrane. Here also you have a membrane. So the entire structure of neuron is actually surrounded by the membrane, which is known as the neuron membrane. And this is also a lipid bilayer structure. Correct? So this membrane also has a lipid bilayer structure. Now this lipid bilayer structure acts as an insulator. What do I mean by insulator? Insulator means somebody who doesn't allow anything else to pass through it. That is called insulator. So this lipid bilayer structure is an insulator in the sense that it does not allow any ions to pass through it. So nobody can pass through the structure as such. So that means it acts as an, I mean nobody in the sense, the ions. So it does not allow the ions to pass through it. Now what can be done if we want ions to pass through it? So for that purpose, we have specific channels known as ion channels. So membrane has the lipid bilayer structure. Now since the lipid bilayer structure is insulator by nature, so there are ion channels present on the membrane, something like this. So these are the channels which can actually allow passage of ions across this membrane, right? Okay, so right now this membrane I am talking about is the neuron membrane, the membrane which is present everywhere surrounding this neuron. So everywhere you have this membrane. Okay, so it is something like this. Let us suppose if this is the neuron membrane, this is the neuron membrane, this is the exoplasm, because right now we are talking about the axon. So inside you have exoplasm and outside is the extracellular fluid. Again, outside is the extracellular fluid. So this is one lipid bilayer structure. Again, this is one lipid bilayer structure. So that is how the neuron membrane is present here. Right? Okay. So now these ion channels, it is not that they can just allow any ions to pass through them. They are also selectively permeable to specific ions. Some of them allow only sodium ions to pass through them. Some of them allow only potassium ions and they do not allow sodium ions to pass through them. So that means these ion channels are also selectively permeable. They are permeable, that is they allow passage of ions, but selectively, only the selected ions. So these ion channels which I am talking about, they are nothing but they are actually transmembrane proteins. That is protein structures which are present across the membrane. I mean they are like, you can say they are deep inside the membrane. They are present in such a way that they provide a tunnel like structure for the ions to pass through them. So now if you try to see how it is present in the axon. Now why are we specifically talking about axon? Because most of the exchange will take place in the axon, like the exchange of the impulse from one neuron to another, that will take place through the axon endings. So now if you talk about the axon part, so this part is the axon. So now in this axon part, how is this layer present? This layer is present somewhat like this. Let us suppose this is a lipid bilayer, and in this lipid bilayer you have tunnels like this, or the ion channels like this. So this is your, this is known as axolemma. This is called axolemma because it is the membrane of the axon. So it is called axolemma, and inside this what is there? Axoplasm. that is the cytoplasm of the axon. Inside, whatever fluid is present, that is exoplasm. And outside, what do you have? The extracellular fluid. So basically, this area is extracellular fluid. This area is also extracellular fluid. And inside, you have exoplasm. So on this side, you have one axolemma. On this side, you have another axolemma. So that is the structure of the neuron membrane. So please understand this structure of the neuron membrane properly, because that is only will be helping you in the next few slides when we start talking about the different potentials. So we are now clear with the structure of the neuron membrane. Now, thank you. Please visit www.examfear.com to watch more videos, attempt free online test, get free study material, find tutors and mentors. Thank you once again.